Okay, hello guys, welcome to CareerDeed. In today's session, we are going to discuss some of the important CTS quantitative aptitude questions. So if you take CTS, there are certain topics, certain type of question that you used to repeat often. So we are going to discuss that kind of question today. So don't skip any part and watch the video till the end. So let's have our first question now. The number of 6-digit even numbers that can be made from the numbers 2, 6, 7, 8, 9, 4 are dash. So you have a 6-digit number here, right? So with this, you have to frame 6-digit even numbers. So totally you will get 6 digits, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, because you have to frame a 6-digit even number. Now, what are all the digits we have? We have 2, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 4. So totally you have 6 digit. From this, you have to frame 6-digit even numbers. So if it is even number, we will be focusing much on the last digit, right? So last digit can be 2, or it can be 6, or it can be 8, or it can be 4, right? So it can be 2 or 6 or 8 or 4. So from this 6-digit, we are choosing the last digit as 2 or 6 or 8 or 4. That means the last digit will be filled in how many ways? So in 4 ways, because it can be a 2 or 6 or 8 or 4. Right, so last digit can be filled in 4 ways. Now, out of these 4 digits, any one digit will occupy the last place. Example, so number 8 get occupied in last place. Okay, now you can occupy, you can fill the first place in how many ways? So now, including the 7 and 9, you have how many digits? So in even numbers, you have 3 numbers, and in odd numbers, you have 7 and 9. So totally, you have 5 digits. Right? So out of the 5 numbers, any one number will occupy the first place. Now, second place can be filled in how many ways? 4 ways, because already out of 5, one number occupied in first place. So remaining you have 4 numbers, second place will be occupied in 4 ways. And next place will be occupied in 3 ways, because you have only 3 numbers, right? Now, you will be having only 2 numbers. So fourth place will be occupied in 2 ways. Now you have only one number. So last place, the fifth place can be occupied in only one way. So totally, how many 6-digit even numbers can be formed? 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 into 4. So this is nothing but 120. 5 factorial is 120. And 120 into 4, how much we get? It is 480, right? So we can frame 480 6-digit even numbers with the digits 2, 6, 7, 8, 9, 4. And one more thing you have to note here is no number repeat more than once. For example, if you fix 8 at last place, that number will not repeat one more time. In case, if you have an option, repetition is allowed. Imagine you have repetition allowed. Repetition of the digits allowed. That means the same number can repeat for any number of times, right? So how many 6-digit even number can be framed? However, the last digit can be any one of these 4 numbers only, right? So it can be a 2 or 6 or 8 or 4, right? So last digit will be filled in only 4 ways. Now imagine you fixed 8 here. That means there is no objection that you can fix 8 here also, right? So the first place can be occupied in how many ways? So you have 6-digit number, right? So first place can be filled in 6 ways. And second digit also can be filled in 6 ways. And third digit can be filled in 6 ways, fourth digit can be filled in 6 ways, and fifth digit can be filled in 6 ways. So simply you can say 6 into 6 into 6 into 6 into 4, that is 6 power 5 into 4. So this will become your answer. Okay, that means the same number can repeat for n number of times, right? But the last digit will be filled in only 4 ways, because it should be an even number, right? So remaining digits can be filled in 6 ways, because you totally have 6 numbers, right? So in 2, 6, 7, 8, 9, 4, you have 6 numbers. So the first, second, third, fourth, and fifth place can be filled in 6 into 6 into 6 into 6 into 6 into, and final digit can be filled in 4 ways. But answer for this question is 480, because here there is no repetition allowed, right? So it is 480 ways. Hope you understood the concept. And moving to second question. Naveen is going on a holiday trip. He wants to pack 4 t-shirts from 6 t-shirts he has. In how many ways can he make his choice? See, if you take CTS, right? So both in CTS and Wipro, now you have certain topics where you get, where the weightage is very high. So the topics are permutation combination, probability, time and work, time speed distance. So this is the four major topics that will give a huge marks in this examination, right? So we are going to discuss some topics related to the some problems related to the particular topics only. Now look at this question. You have six t-shirts. From that you have to select four t-shirts. So the question is purely based on combination, right? So if you have six t-shirts, from that you have to select four t-shirts. So in how many ways it is possible? In 6C4 ways, right? From six you have to select four. So in 6C4 ways it is possible. We know the value of NCR is equivalent to n factorial by n minus r factorial into r factorial. That is 6C4 can be written as 6 factorial by 6 minus 4 is 2 factorial into 4 factorial, right? See, we know the shortcut to solve this kind of problems easily, but I'm explaining using traditional method, right? So I will explain the shortcut also, but this is the traditional method. So 6 factorial can be written as 6 into 5 into 4 factorial, because at bottom you have 4 factorial, right? That can be easily cancelled. So 4 factorial and 4 factorial can be easily cancelled. So what is the value of 2 factorial? It is 2, right? So cancel this 2. So 2 into 3 is 6. So 3 into 5, 15. So in 15 ways, you can select 4 t-shirts out of 6 t-shirts. So answer for this question is option A. Now, what is the shortcut? Now, how can we solve this 6C4 easily? Now, we know the 6C4 value is equivalent to 6C2. Why? What is the difference between 6 and 4? It is 2, right? So difference between 6 and 4 is 2. So this is equivalent to 6C2. For example, if you have 7C4, it is equivalent to difference between 7 and 4 is 3. So this one will be equivalent to 7C3. That's it. Now, how we can write the 6C2? Now you have to write the 6 factorial up to two places. That means 6 into 5. You have to write only two places. At bottom, you have to write this 2 factorial, right? So you have 2. So you have to write the 2 factorial. That is 2 into 1. Do you understood, right? So 6C2 can be written as 6 into 5 by 2 into 1. So just cancel this. 3 into 5 is 15. So this becomes your answer. Hope you understood, right? Now moving to third question. The product of a number and its multiplicative inverse is dash. Such an easy question, right? So you can imagine any value. For example, I take it as 5. The product of a number. So let this be the original number and its multiplicative inverse. So multiplicative inverse means 1 by 5. Right, so if you multiply this, what is the product? So 5 cancel, you are left with only 1. So answer for this question is 1. So you can take any number. So this is just for reference. Hope you understood, right? Now moving to next question. Okay, if the LCM and HCF of two numbers are 78 and 13 respectively, the product of two numbers can be expressed as dash. Okay, now we know product of LCM and HCF is equivalent to product of the two numbers. For example, if you take 12 and let's say 16, okay? So this is just for an example. So if you have two numbers, 12 and 16, right? So what is the LCM? So LCM of 12 and 16, we get 48, right? So this is 48. So this is LCM of these two numbers. And what is the HCF of 12 and 16? So highest common factor of 12 and 16 is 4, right? So this is HCF. Now, if you multiply these two numbers, so 12 into 16 will be obviously equivalent to 4 into 48, right? So 12 into 16 will be equivalent to 4 into 48. So what is 4 into 48? So 48 into 2, you get 96. 96 into 2, you get 192. Similarly, 16 into 12 also, you get 192, right? That means product of any two numbers is equivalent to its LCM into HCF. Now, they are asking you to find the product of the two numbers that can be expressed in what factors, right? Now, instead of multiplying these two numbers, so 78 into 13, instead of multiplying these two numbers, just try to find the factors of 78. So what is factor of 78? So 78 can be written as 2 into, so actually it is not 78, so we can take it as 156. So that is the actual question. So this is not 78, so it is 156 into 13, okay? So the LCM of two numbers is 156 and HCF is 13. Okay, now 156 can be written as 2 into 78 and 78 can be written as 2 into 39 and 39 can be written as 3 into 13. Now, what is factors of the number 156? So factors of the number 156 is 2 into 2 into 3 into 13. And you have highest common factor, that is 13, right? Now 156 into 13 can be written as 2 into 2 into 3 into 13 into 13, because 156 into 13 is nothing but 2 into 2 into 3 into 13 into 13, right? So both are same, right? So they are asking you to express this product in factors. So the factors of 156 into 13 is nothing but option C, 2 into 2 into 3 into 13 into 13. So this becomes your answer, right? See, I have included the link of LCM and HCF in description. So if you want detailed explanation on the quality of LCM and HCF, so please have a look at it. Now moving to next question. What is the value of I power 36? We know I is an imaginary number, right? So imaginary, what is the value of imaginary number? We know I square is equivalent to minus 1. So we have to keep in our mind always. All right, so imaginary value square number is equivalent to minus 1. Now you have I power 36. So how we can write I power 36? That is nothing but I square to the whole power. We can write it as 18, right? Because a power m to the whole power n is equivalent to a power m into n. So I square to the whole power 18. So what is the value of I square? We know I square is minus 1. So what is minus 1 power 18? Minus 1 power 18 is nothing but 1. Right, so minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1 up to 18 times you get plus 1. So the value is equivalent to plus 1. Right, hope you understood. So this is the answer. Now moving to next question. What will be the remainder when 139 power 34 into 177 power 63 into 603 power 272 is divided by 2? So when you divide all these numbers by 2, what is the remainder? We know what is the remainder, right? So if you divide 5 by 2, what is the remainder? So 5 by 2. So 2 into 2 is 4. The remainder is 1. So the remainder for 5 by 2 is 1, right? They are not asking quotient. They are asking what is the remainder. But here you have number raised power 34. So here answer lies in finding the unit digit. Now 139 power 34, that means 139 into 139 into 139 up to 34 times you have to multiply 139. Now if you divide this by 2, that will consume a lot of time, right? So you can't imagine the traditional method. So how can we solve this? Now 139 into 139, just we are trying to find the last digit. So 139 into 139, right? So what will be the last digit? 9 into 9 is 81, so carry 8. We don't want to worry about that. So when you multiply 9 power 2 times, you get 1 at last. Now, if you multiply one more 9, right? So 9 into 9 is 81. 81 into 9 is, 81 into 9. So in 81, take that 1 and multiply with this 9. So you get 9. That means 9 power 1, you get 9. 9 square is 81. So last digit will be 1. 9 cube is 729. So last digit will be 9. 9 power 4, again you will get 1. That means 9 power odd number, you get 9 at last. 9 power even number, you get 1 at last, right? So here you have 9 power odd number or even number. So it is 34, it's an even number, right? So 9 power 34, what do you get? That means the even number, right? So 9 power even number, you get 1 at last, right? Okay, now coming for 7, 177 power 63. Right, now coming to cyclicity of number 7. So cyclicity means after how many times the same number will repeat for once again, right? For example, if you take 7 power 1, 7 power 1 is 7 and 7 square is 49. Last digit will be 9. 7 cube, what is 7 cube? 343. So last digit will be 3 and 7 power 4, right? So it is 343 into 7. So that will consume a little time, right? So to find 7 power 4, in 343, take the last digit 3 and multiply with 7. 7 into 3, 21. So last digit will be 1. Now, if you take 7 power 5, again, the cyclicity will go from 7, right? That is 7931, 7931, 7931. So the same number will repeat for every 4 times, right? Okay, now you have 177 power 63. 177 power 63. Now, this 63, right? So just we try to divide the 63 by 4. So why we are dividing by 4? Because we are checking the cyclicity of the number 7. Because we know for every 4 times the same number will repeat, right? So 63 by 4. So what you get 63 by 4? Now if you divide the 63 by 4, what is the remainder you get? You get the remainder 3. Right, so 63 by 4, you get remainder 3. Because 4 into 15 is 60, the remainder is 3. That means you have to look 7 power 3. right? So what is the last digit of 7 power 3? You get 3, right? So last digit of 177 power 63 is 3, right? Okay, next, 603 power 272, right? 603 power 272. See, we have already posted a video on how to find unit digit when a number raised in power, right? So I have included the link in description also. So if you want, you can have a look at it, right? So there I have provided a detailed explanation on how to find the unit digit of any number raised to power, right? Okay, now it is 603 power 272. Okay, now 3 power 1, the last digit will be 3. 3 square, the last digit will be 9. 3 power 3, the last digit will be 27. I mean 27, so the last digit will be 7. 3 power 4, it is 81, right? So last digit will be 8. 3 power 5, you get 243. So last digit will be 3. So cyclicity of the number 3 is also 4. For every 4 times, the same number will repeat, right? So it is 3971, 3971, 3971, right? So the same number will repeat for every 4 times. So here you have 603 power 272. So you can't find 603 power 272 traditional, right? So traditionally you can't find. So what we can do, you can divide this 272 by 4, because every 4 times these same number will repeat, right? So you are dividing this 272 by 4. So it is 6 4s are 24, carry 3, and 8 4s are 32. Now you are not getting any remainder. So remainder is 0. So if you get remainder 0, you have to choose 4, right? So it is 3 power 4. Because you will not get a remainder as 4, right? Because whenever you divide a number by 4, right? So you will not get a remainder equivalent to 4. For example, assume you have 25. So when you divide this 25 by 4, what is the remainder? Remainder is 1, because 6 4s are 24, the remainder is 1. If you divide 26 by 4, what is the remainder you get? Remainder will be equivalent to 2. 6 4s are 24, remainder is 2. 27 by 4, you get remainder 3, right? So 28 by 4, you will not get any remainder, because 7 4s are 28. So you will not get any remainder. That means in no case you will get remainder 4. Right, that means if you get a remainder 0, you have to choose 4 only, right? So what is at the base of 4? I mean at the bottom of 4, you have 1, right? So 3 power 4 is, the last digit will be 1, right? So last digit of 603 power 272 will be 1, right? So when you divide this 1 by 2, right? So when you divide this 1 by 2, what is the remainder? Remainder will be 1. If you divide this 3 by 2, here also you get the remainder 1. When you divide this 1 by 2, there also you get remainder 1. So remainder 1 into 1 into 1, you get remainder 1 only, right? So when you add that remainder 1, that is 139 power 34 by 2, you get remainder 1. 177 power 63 by 2 also, you get remainder 1. 603 power 272 by 2 also, you get remainder 1. So if you multiply all the remainders, that is 1 into 1 into 1, you get 1 only, right? So answer for this question is option C, 1. And I have included the link on how to find unit digit and tens digit of any number in description. Just have a look at it, because these kind of questions are very important in CTS. Okay, now moving to next question. Okay, Nirmala bought a car worth rupees 4,50,000 4 years ago. If the value of the car depreciates over time at a fixed rate of 10% per annum, then what will be the present worth of the car? Okay, so this question is based on successive percentage. So Nirmala bought a car for 4,50,000, right? And so this is 100%. While purchasing, this is 100%. Now its value is depreciating 10% per annum. For how many years it is depreciating? For 4 years, right? So every year only the value remains 90% of the actual value. So first year, the value will be only 90% of 4,50,000. Next year from this again, a 90% will be remained. And next year again, another 90% will be remained. And next year, another 90% will be remained. So if you cancel it, you will get the answer, right? So if you cancel the 0 and 0, 0 and 0, and 0, 0, and 0, 0. Yes, 9 into 9, 81, 9 into 9, 81. So what is 81 square? So 81 square, you get, 8, 16, 1. So it is 6561. So you have to multiply the 6561 with 45. You get the answer, right? So I think I included the wrong options, but if you multiply this, you will get the answer. So it is 5, 6 5 is 33 and 25 and 28 2 and 30, 32. And again 4, 24, 2, 22, 2, 26. So its value will be 2,95,245. Right, so this will be the answer, right? So I know the options here mentioned are wrong. So answer for this question is 2,95,245. So this becomes your answer. Hope you understood the concept, right? So moving to next question. Okay, here you have the next question. A bell rings after every 3 seconds. Another bell rings after every 5 seconds. And the third one rings after every 16 seconds. How many times do they ring together in half an hour? Okay, and we know the answer lies in LCM, right? So first bell ring for every 3 seconds and second bell ring for every 5 seconds and third bell ring for every 16 seconds, right? And they are asking in half an hour, how many times all the bells will ring together? All the bells will ring together. That means the answer lies in common intersection. That means LCM of 3, 5 and 16. So what is LCM of 3, 5 and 16? We know 3, 5 and 16. So 3 and 5 are prime numbers. Right, so you have two different prime numbers and 16 is completely different of this prime. That means the 16 is not the multiple of 3 and 5. Imagine if you have 10. So the 10 is multiple of 5, but the 16 is don't have any relationship between 3 and 5. So how to find LCM? 3 into 5 into 16, that's it. So what is 3 into 5 into 16? That is 15 into 16. So you get 160 plus 80, you get 240. So 240. So for every 240 seconds, all the bells will ring together. So you have 240 times. Please don't choose that. Okay. So that means for every 240 seconds, all the bells will ring together. So 240 seconds means how many minutes? 240 by 60. So that means for every 4 minutes, all the bells will ring together. Now imagine on the first minute, all the bells ring together, right? And by fifth minute, all the bells ring together. Then by ninth minute, all the bells ring together. Then by 13th minute, all the bells ring together. That means for every 4 minutes, the bells will ring, right? So next it will ring by 17th minute. Next it will ring by 21st minute. After that, it will ring by 25th minute. After that, it will ring by 29th minute. Right. So first minute. So 1 plus 4 is 5. 5 plus 4 is 9. 9 plus 4 is 13. 13 plus 4 is 17. 17 plus 4 is 21. 21 plus 4 is 25. 25 plus 4 is 29. So how many times it will ring? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 times it will ring together. So some people will work like this. So they have 30 minutes. So if it ring for every 4 minutes, so 30 by 4, they will take 7. So that is actually wrong because already by the first minute, all of them ringed together. So you have to include that first minute also. So totally it ring for 8 times, right? So answer for this question is 8 times. See, there is a shortcut to find LCM in fraction of seconds. And again, you could see the link appearing at the top, right? So if you click it, you will get the shortcut on how to find LCM in lesser time. Okay, now moving to next question. So in a class of 800 students, 4/5 of them own cars. Okay, so you have 800 students. Out of 800, 4/5 of the student own the car. So if you cancel this, you get 160. 160 into 4, 640. So 640 students have the car. If 15 out of 16 of them own BMW, then how many own BMW? Okay, so you have 640 students who own car. Out of that, 15 out of 16 have BMW, right? So if you cancel this, it is how many times? So 16 into 4 is 64, so it is 40 times. So you get 440 into 15, 600, right? Because 15 can be written as 10 plus 5. So 40 into 5 is 400. Half of that 400 is 40 into 5, that is 200. 400 plus 200 is 600, right? So that is the shortcut, okay? So totally 600 students own BMW car. Hope you understood, right? Okay. Okay, which is better? A successive discount of 60% and 30% or a discount of 70%? A successive discount of 60% and 30%. Imagine you are looking at a product which is marked 100 rupees. Now you are getting successive discount of 60% and 30%. So first, if you get a 60% discount, you have to pay only 40% of it, that is 40 by 100. And from that, you are getting a 30% discount. That means you have to pay a 70% of it. So 60% means, so from 100, you have to subtract 60. That is 40% you have to pay. Next, you are getting a 30% discount. That means from 100, you have to subtract 30. That is 70 by 100. If you cancel this, you get 7 4s are 28. So you have to pay how many rupees? 28 rupees finally. Right. Now, look at this. The discount of 70%. So this is a flat 70% discount. So first, for that 100 rupees marked, you are getting 70% discount. That means you have to pay 30% of it, right? So if out of 100 rupees, if 70% is the discount, you have to pay only 30%, right? So it is into 30 by 100. So if you cancel this, you have to pay 30 rupees. So which is better? Paying 20 rupees is better or 30 rupees is better? Paying 20 rupees is better, right? So what a successive discount of 60% and 30% is better, right? So which option you have to choose? So you have to choose none of this, right? So which is better? A successive discount of 60% and 30%. But you don't have that option here, right? Because you have 40% and 30%. So if it is 60% and 30%, you can choose it, right? But you don't have 60% and 30%. So you have to choose none of the above, right? Hope you understood all the problems of this session, right? So in upcoming session, I have some more problems. We shall discuss that. Until that, stay connected with CareerD Training Solutions. And please click the like button and share the video to your friends. Thanks a lot for watching and have a nice day. Wish you all the very best to crack your CTS. Thanks a lot. Have a nice day.